Joining Hello. Us now, P3 PWD Port List Representative Rowena Guanzon, Congresswoman-elect Guanzon. Good morning, Mayong Aga. Welcome to the program.
Good morning. Can you hear me?
Yes, loud and clear, Congresswoman Guanzon. Now, let me go straight to your reaction. Finally, you are now representative. At the start of this year, you were commissioner of the COMELEC, now Representative Guanzon. How does it feel after all the controversies?
Well, as you know, I thrive on controversy. As I quote Speaker Nancy Pelosi, politics is combat. So I was trained for this since I was in my mother's womb. But I feel confident because I know that I'm in the right and the law is on my side. As you, as COMELEC spokesperson has explained, the November 15 deadline applied only to the events involving party list nominees before or on May 9. After that, the party list law itself does not prohibit the substitution of a representative of a party list when there is a vacancy. And that vacancy happened in the case of P3PWD when our first nominee, Grace Yanesa, had to resign because her daughter has a very grave illness, and the number two to number five also resigned for their own reasons.
Congresswoman Guanzon, I have to get used to calling you Congresswoman Guanzon. How do you address allegations, though, that this is really a platform for abuse of the party system, because anybody can withdraw after the elections, and there could be allegations of pressuring those nominees? There are five nominees and all of them withdrew after the election.
You know, the party list is by itself an entity. In our case, we also have a non-stock, non-profit organization registered with the SEC. So we have a board there. We also have a board in the party list. We are a genuine party list of a marginalized, genuine sector. All persons with disability, those with chronic illnesses, and children with special needs. We are not some political front. You should not be worried about people like me substituting. You should be worried about politicians substituting after they misrepresent to be a genuine marginalized sector. But the PWD party list is not, does not so mislead you. It published its nominees. In fact, when my substitution was submitted by our board, we also published our five names with my name first on the list. And if I were disqualified, let's say by reason that I am a dual citizen, then the public or any person, any citizen could have stopped the COMELEC from doing so. But, you know, my oppositors are doing this for personal grudges. That's the trouble. Because the public can tell between these political and personal grudges the difference with genuine legal grounds. So why should be worried about abuse? Let's say it doesn't involve me, okay? Because you know me, I will not abuse. Why do I have to abuse? I don't live my life that way. Let's say it's not me that's involved, okay? But in the party list, you see, has its own rules, has its own, bylaws, and it should be able internally to decide who will represent them, is it not? Why is it that the other people, like my nemesis wants to oppose my substitution? Who is he? He has no locus standi. He has no standing in court for saying that I cannot be substituted by my party list. You see, people do not understand. What people don't understand is that the Constitution provided for it. There is a law that provides for this mechanics and allows the substitution after a party list already wins a seat. After it wins a seat. There is a vacancy. Those are the two things that must occur before a party list can substitute its nominees. Now, if the nominees do not want to resign, then they should say to the COMELEC that I do not want to resign. I'm just being forced. But it is not my oppositors outside of my party list to say that I coerced the nominees to resign. By golly. Mm-hmm. I think it is the people, the voters, who will complain if I do not sit. Why? Mm-hmm. Because they saw me on stage, they saw me on TV, they heard me on radio. I spent my own money for our campaign because I believe that it is long overdue that the persons with disability must have a voice in Congress and a strong voice. That is why Grace Inessa and the other nominees and the board decided that when Ms. Inessa said that my daughter has a terminal grave illness, I agreed to take over as campaign manager, as funder, as you know, my whole family got involved with it. My former clients, our PWD networks nationwide, because the people, most people, believe that when they voted for P3 PWD, they were voting for Rowena Guanzon. So why should I sit? Why should I apologize for this when the people who voted for P3 PWD number 54 in their ballot voted because they believed, one, Rowena Guanzon was representing it, number two, that the PWDs and people with chronic illnesses must have a voice in Congress, a strong voice.
Congresswoman, just to get this out of the way, what about the four other nominees of P3 PWD party list? Did they also resign because of personal reasons?
Yes, but that's their business, is it not? What about you? You can also quit this job for personal reasons. Mm-hmm. Everybody has the freedom to do so, but nobody outside our party list can say that they have a right to question why our nominees resign. Mm-hmm. Because if you look at the track record of COMELEC, we allowed. Oh, in the case of Marino, in the case mm-hmm. of Anak Kalusugan, Mike Defensor, in the case even of Marco Leta, who had an issue because he ran for senator, but he withdrew, you see? He withdrew because he knew already that he was going to substitute. His intention was to substitute in his party list. Mm-hmm. That is even a, what do you call this? That is an issue. There is no legal issue with my substitution, but in Marco Leta's case, there was a legal issue, you see? Mm-hmm. And that you can take that up to the Supreme Court if you have standing. You see, the trouble is, this. My nemesis is not a lawyer. He did not even graduate in college. He got kicked out from somewhere, you know, whatever. And then he pretends to know the law. But you see, all of their oppositions were dismissed by the COMELEC. Now they petition in the Supreme Court to issue a TRO. There is nothing to restrain because I already took my oath yesterday. Mm-hmm. And on Monday, I will report to the, I will go to the House of Representatives to request the Secretary General for a ground floor office because our constituents are persons with disability. I myself, I'm a person with disability. If you think I can dance on stage and walk, it's because I had a lot of treatment for that before mm-hmm. I go up the stage. Oh, you don't know all the pain I go through to have treatments just to go up the stage and dance and, you know, make those speeches. Mm-hmm. So yeah, so I'm saying, what else? Ano pa? What else?
Congresswoman. Congresswoman.
You know, Mike, I think it's because it's me. Mm-hmm. It's me.
They're opposing. See,
they want to get at me. Well, so sorry, guys. I mean, hey, you're not members of Congress. I will work with my fellow members of Congress, and I know that they know that they can work with me because even as commissioner, they know that I have always been fair to them, even members of Congress.
Congresswoman, you opposed the substitution of Mr. Candema in the Duterte Youth Party list. How different is this from your case?
In my case, I am not overage in the youth mm-hmm. sector. I am mm-hmm. not disqualified from substituting because I'm a registered voter. And under mm-hmm. our bylaws, I am a member of the PWD party list. I myself am a PWD. I have as you saw in my taking, my nephew Khalil has is a cutie, you know. He has Down syndrome, but he can interact. And my nephew has autism. I know how it feels to have a family member of your family to have palsy, autism, socio-psychological disabilities. I know. So I am your best representative in Congress for that. Now, what's the difference? Because, goddammit, was overage when I found out in the list. I said, no, this cannot be. You cannot sit in a youth sector party list. Over 40 ka na, hindi ba? Oh, so that, in fact, the commission in bank agreed with me. It was a unanimous vote. And I was not even the ponente. The ponente was the commissioner from Davao. And to think that he's using the name of President Duterte, I don't even know if President Duterte allowed him to use that name. But since nobody opposed, okay, you use whatever you want to use. Katsupoy party list, go ahead, you know. But if it tends to make a mockery of our elections, we will deny it, you see.
So just to be clear, Congresswoman.
He's overage, so we allowed his wife to sit. The second nominee, there's his wife. Now, this wife now is again overage. Eh, ubusin na lang nila pamilya nila ng hindi overage. Sige. But that's allowed by law. But come to think of it, is that a genuine organization whose advocacy is anti-communism? Is that marginalized when you say, oh, these people are anti-communist, are marginalized? That is a subject matter, in fact, of a cancellation of registration.
Congressman, so just to be clear, you oppose Cardema substitution.
Cancel our registration. I will also petition to cancel the registration.
Now, just to be clear. All right, Congresswoman, just to be clear. So you're not opposed to the very idea of substitution itself. You were just opposed to the very credentials of Mr. Cardema substituting.
He was disqualified. So, for example, if he was also a dual citizen, he would have been disqualified also. But when you represent a youth sector under the party list law, you must be of a certain age and below, and he was already over age. Hindi na sa youth, dugyot na siya eh. Eh, namimilit siya eh. Ano ba talaga ang gusto niya? And then he makes threats. He threatened me, you know? He said that in a duel, he used the word headshot, that he will shoot me in the head. I'm filing a complaint against him for a threat next week. I'm also filing next week a complaint in the Ombudsman for violation of the Code of Ethics. I'm also filing against him a million peso suit in Bacolod for damages to my honor and my reputation. Again, ubusin ko yung pera niya sa gastos niya sa attorney's fees. After all, I have a lot of lawyers. And I was a practicing lawyer and professor myself. And I don't mind spending money for attorney's fees. I like paying lawyers. Siya, sasakit ang bulsa niya. Sasakit ang loob niya every time babayad siya sa abogado niya because he's not used to litigation. But it is high time. And my family said, it is high time that you sue that.
All right, Congresswoman, just on the issue of substitution, because you're saying that the resolution of the COMELEC applies only prior to the elections of this year. Isn't there quite a disparity here? Because prior to the elections, you can only substitute on the basis of incapacity or death. But after elections, there's no such requirement. If there's a vacancy, you can have a nominee substituted. So isn't there a disparity in the rules here?
Because that is the law, attorney.
Now, I'm asking for your opinion. I'm asking for your opinion now. Yes, but I'm asking for your thoughts.
This is the COMELEC's interpretation of the law. And Attorney Lau Dianco has already explained that under the Party List Act, there is no prohibition from substituting a nominee once there is a vacant seat. It is between the Speaker and us. The party list.
That is correct, Congresswoman.
Why are you adding to the law
Just the policy, just on the policy, Congresswoman. It's in the law, but just on the policy.
The COMELEC can only make policy and rules that interpret the law. And that has always been clear to us ever since I was there 7 years na ako dyan.
Mm-hmm.
We have always allowed the substitution on the ground of resignation for whatever reason. Somebody said he had cancer. All right. Mike Defensor appeared before the law director because I said, I don't want fake withdrawals. You verify if that man really is sick. Okay. Mm-hmm. It's notarized. They verified. They spoke to him. So we allowed Mike Defensor to substitute. Right. Marino also substituted. Now Marcuneta substituted. Now Agimat also substituted Ryan.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah, that's clear, Congresswoman. Now, on the issue, on another issue, Congresswoman, because you started this year as a commissioner of COMELEC, now you are part of the House of Representatives. Some people might be of the view that how did your position as COMELEC commissioner affect this whole entire journey? I mean, there could be allegations.
Did I commit acts of fraud? Do you mean?
No, Congresswoman. Just the fact that isn't there a potential conflict of interest because you were manning the elections retirement?
There's no ethical issue here. Mm-hmm. I was not the commissioner who granted the registration of P3PWD. It was mm-hmm. in the second division of Commissioner Socorro in Tingnao, the acting chair.
And you joined P3PWD after your stay in
COMELEC. After I resigned. Mm-hmm. And in fact, after. I was really going to campaign for them because, mm-hmm. you know, that is my sector. And I know the people in the board they're really PWDs or family members. You can... Makata ka UP yun, ha?
Mm-hmm.
Galing kaya nun. Eh, kayo nga dyan, ipakita nyo nga mga board nyo. Oh, meron kayong mga taga-UP dyan, tatlo. Isang Miriam College, isang Bugado. I'm saying, I was not the one who approved the registration of P3PWD. It never reached the unbank because mm-hmm. it was granted at the division level. And I said I will campaign and help you after I resign. And mm-hmm. then when Ms. Inessa said, you know, I cannot do it anymore. I have to go to the hospital with my daughter several times a week. I have to care for her. You know, those are true facts. We are not lying to you. Why do mm-hmm. I have to lie to you? Do I have to be congresswoman and spend millions and millions of my inheritance and what do you call this pension just to be congresswoman? Why do I need to be there? I personally don't need this for my ambition.
mm-hmm.
Why will I even spend my own money for this ambition? Ambition lang ito. But it's really that it is long overdue. The persons with disability must have a voice in Congress. Government agencies now must make sure that they give us what is due us under the law, or we'll make hell for them in the budget hearings.
Mm-hmm.
The OH, PhilHealth, the SWD. Bakit wala kaming PhilHealth? PWD na kami, wala pa rin kaming PhilHealth. Bakit daw? Sagot nila sa akin. Kasi mm-hmm. po ma'am, hindi na-upload yung name nila sa from the LGU to the DOH to the PhilHealth. Pambihira naman kayo. Mm-hmm. Dapat isuna namin kayo sa ombudsman for gross negligence.
Ang tagal ng
batas na yan ni Loren Legarda, wala pa rin kaming PhilHealth.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know how hard it is for poor people who are there lying in bed with cerebral palsy or stroke and you don't have PhilHealth. You just don't know how hard it is to be poor. But now, I'm going to sit in Congress in the minority so that I can be in all these committees. And they know that I mean business.
Mm-hmm. Congresswoman, how do you think that expose in February, in January, when you released your own opinion on the Marcos case, how do you think that affected the chances of your party list group in this year's elections? Because you gained fame because of that, because you were seen as a sort of a hero to expose the supposed delay in the release of the COMELEC resolution. And yet when you decided to substitute as a nominee, there were some groups, there were some sectors who were saying that that expose could have been politically motivated. How would you address those allegations?
That's a lot of bull. Mm-hmm. That would have been fabricated if my opinion was fabricated. But as you see, I published it. Mm-hmm. You should read that opinion, by the way. It's a
yes.
Magnum opus. That's a lot of bull. I did not arrive, be where I am today, if I am deceitful. Mm-hmm. And by the way, being deceitful is not in our bloodline, you know? If you know the generations of Bilyena Guanzon since the 1500s. But that is really not true. That is a malicious thought. I am surprised that you are even saying it here. But since you like controversies, go ahead.
I was trying to get your reactions and to get it out of the way because there were some
of
sectors.
Yeah.
All right. Now, Congresswoman, the Supreme Court petition against your substitution, you're saying it's now moot. There's no chance that the Supreme Court will take it on as an issue that's capable of repetition but evading review?
Well, for one thing, I understand the Supreme Court justices are in isolation now.
Mm-hmm.
Because there is one incident, COVID suspicion there, mm-hmm. in the Supreme Court. The other thing is, what, that it's a novel issue? How can it be a novel issue when it has been done before? Some mm-hmm. other people have already petitioned the Supreme Court before. Mm-hmm. In fact, this disqualification of cancellation of registration of Kabataan, of Gabriela, this will all go to the Supreme Court. And how can the Supreme Court restrain an act of the COMELEC that is already done? Mm-hmm. It is now the jurisdiction, in my opinion, in my humble opinion as a practicing lawyer and former professor of the UP College of Law, the issue now should be before the HRET, the House of Representatives Electoral Tribunal, no longer with the COMELEC. It is out of the COMELEC's hands. I have taken my oath. On Monday, I will receive my PIN as member of Congress. By the way, I don't like to use that PIN, but they said I have to use it. So I'll just use it inside.
Mm-hmm. And is this going to be the same view with respect to that pending COMELEC, pending Supreme Court petitions against Marcos with respect to his presidency? Because he has taken his oath, he will take his oath on.
Never mind. His problems are his own. He's already in the Supreme Court. Ask me another question.
All right. So, what are your priorities as party list representative, P3PWD?
We're going to file at least 10 priority bills on the day of the SONA or before the SONA. And that will come out of a consultation. Because I told you, we are a genuine consultative marginalized sector. And I already asked my friend and PWD and advocate Carmen Zubiaga, former chair of the National Disabilities Affairs Office, to be the convener of this consultation. From that consultation, we will know our priority bills. And we will also form a consultative council, which will be from different sectors. Children with special needs, children, persons with diseases, illnesses, lupus, leukemia, HIV. HIV/AIDS, by the way. There are some LGUs are not issuing PWD cards to HIV, persons with this HIV. That is a grave illness. That is a chronic illness. Why are you not? That's the trouble. That's why I want also to appeal to the League of Cities and League of Municipalities to instruct their city social welfare officers to issue PWD cards for persons with HIV and AIDS. Mm-hmm. Anyway, that's the way it's going to be. But one of our priorities really is to make sure that our PWDs get filled. Mm-hmm. And also that I know this has to be worked out. But we also want a social pension for them, for those especially who cannot already go out of the house. Mm-hmm. Children who have, for example, palsy and cannot walk, you see. So I I really want to be a member of the health committee for this. Mm-hmm. And the social services committee because of this. Electoral mm-hmm. reform, I'll probably sit as a member there because, well, I don't know. I guess they have to concede that I am the election law expert there in Congo. Mm-hmm. So
and I'll
probably sit there. But it's the appropriations committee that has a lot of clout in these things. And I will join the minority just to make sure that the budget of these government agencies, really, that the persons with disability and those with chronic illnesses will get our fair share mm-hmm. in the government budget of government agencies, especially health, PAGCOR, DSWD, and PhilHealth, of course.
And let me get that clear, Congresswoman. You will join the minority?
Do I look like I'm in the majority?
No, because there was a photo.
What can I do, you know? What can I do? Right? They will always treat me as minority, you know? I can join the minority because in this country, you can be on either side because the party list really did not have it ran on its own, right? Mm-hmm. But for now, I think the best way is to just join the minority so I can usig there, you know? Taga-usig mm-hmm. na lang ako dyan sa mga government agencies na yan the next 3 years. I hope they will support my bills. Because if they don't support my bills, I will not support theirs.
mm-hmm. Despite the fact,
combat, my friend, Speaker Nancy Pelosi. I'm not going to be pakem-kems there because that's not my personality. I have to get things done in 3 years.
Mm-hmm. Despite the fact that PWD supported the speakership of Martin Romualdez, you're not joining the majority.
We have not yet voted. Speaker Romualdez and I, we know each other because he's from UP, you know. Mm. And a lot of his brads in Upsilon voted for me, just as my brads in Sigma Rho and Delta Lambda Sigma voted for me. You know, us from the UP College of Law, we like to vote for bright people. No offense again, ha? That's supposed to be a joke. Kayo talaga?
Yeah, I get that, Congressman.
But you know, we have not yet voted for Speaker Martin Romualdez. Mm-hmm. Because when I went to that lunch, I was just guest there. That's why I was just there at the back. Mm-hmm. But you know, he's a very courteous, well-bred person. He approached me there at the back. Mm-hmm. His wife, even Congresswoman Yeda, sat with me in my table. So, yes, you noticed the pictures. I was just seated there. They approached me.
So that's not a sign of any endorsement at all, because that's what's been reported in some write-ups.
It's also not a sign of opposition, is it not? It was a sign of good manners. Mm-hmm. Even Sandro Marcos, who was soon to be congressman, approached me and offered his hand. What am I to do? Reject his hand? Mm-hmm. He's going to be congressman also. I will have to see him there in the lobby. We will bump into each other. Do not expect me to behave according to your standards. Mm-hmm. I'm Rowena Guanzon. I was brought up by very bright father and mother and patriots, war heroes. I have my own standards in my family and my true north. Di ba? Kaya, why did I accept his son? Why did Tama na. Tatapos na eleksyon, ha? Mm-hmm. I'm going to focus on my work now.
Congresswoman, what are the prospects?
Just support me. Pray for me.
All right. We will. We will pray for you, Congresswoman. But as a final question, you said you're joining the minority. What are the prospects of the minority under a Marcos presidency?
That is why it is a brave thing to do. Mm-hmm. And I always like to do the brave things. But if they say, you know, in the house naman, there's really konti lang sila dun eh. Mm-hmm. Sabi nila, ma'am, you join the minority, itatag ka nila na left, na communist, mga tanga, sabi ko. Kayo nga dyan, you check na your class origin and mine, kung sino tayo sa atin ang pwedeng magkomunista. Ako, magkukomunista? Ikaw kaya, mas bagay ka magkomunista kasi mahirap ka kahit noon pa 1500s. Oh, class origin mo yun eh. Oh. So, I'm saying, sa ngayon, you ask me, saan ako magjo-join? My inclination is the minority because my objective nga is to usig, fiscalize the government agencies that are holding money that PWDs must have a share in. Eh kung majority ako, I have to defend the budget of DOH. But of course, internally, you can also negotiate that. The ops, ano yan, dapat 10% dyan at least will go to PWD concerns. Dapat the LGU total income, and I want to pass that law, and I want, of course, I hope the mayors will also support us that if there is a 5% for gender, can we please have a minimum of 5% of your total income for PWD concerns. Yan po ang aking appeal sa mga mayors. Kaya susulatan ko po ang League of Cities, League of Municipalities, pupunta po ako sa kanilang meetings. Sasabihin ko talaga, oh, kumpanyeros y kumpanyeras. Nag-mayor din naman ako noon. Pahirapan. Right. But when I left, Cadiz City was a first-class city and it had a surplus income. When I inherited a bankrupt city treasury, I know it used to be a mayor.
But all right.
I also know that you, mayors, have a lot of space in your hearts for your persons with disability. Hindi naman yan mapupunta sa akin. Tao din, tao nyo yan eh. Bumoboto din naman yan sa inyo. Di ba? Mm-hmm. So, I don't think I'll have a problem with mayors at all. So, I'm very optimistic that when we assume office, and when we assume office, it should be fun because we will have our friends there and network, the Philippine Blind Union, the Disability Affairs Officers of some LGUs can join us, children with special needs, persons in wheelchairs. So it's for us, our first day of office is really a victory for our sector. Not for me. I do not believe that I just want to be famous. I'm already famous. You know, I cannot even eat in peace in restaurants anymore. I cannot finish my meal. People want to have pictures with me and I gladly give it because kayo naman ang nagpapanalo sa akin.
All right, on that note, unfortunately, we don't have much time anymore, Congressman.
Maraming salamat po sa inyong suporta sa persons with disability. Maraming salamat po.
All right, and daghang salamat, Congresswoman Rowena Gonzon, for joining us this morning.